Hello, welcome to FOMA Solutions. This is our first lesson in introductory analysis, and I want to begin by looking at the real number system. So over the years, we've looked at a set of numbers which have evolved, and bringing them together gave us the real number system. And actually, we can take the analogy of a farmer, animal farmer, looking at how to record the number of animals he or she is having on his farm. And so, starting with counting of the number of the animals, 1, 2, 3. Then we came to accept this system of numbers, which we call the natural numbers. So the first set of numbers we have are natural numbers. Now we denote that with this symbol. So as said earlier, we have 1, 2, 3. And so on. So the 3 dots here is quite significant. It tells us that these numbers continue into infinity. Alright, so these numbers were enough for this particular farm. Until you realize that, okay, now what if he goes to his farm and there is no animal there? So we don't have any animal there. So how would that be recorded? So this brings into being the idea of 0. So 0 added to these numbers gave birth to another set of numbers which we refer to as whole numbers. So we look at the second set of numbers, whole numbers. So with capital W, we have whole numbers beginning from 0, 1, 2, 3, and this continues. These numbers, but okay. Alright. Then the farmer also realized that, all right, now he or she don't have not having any animal. He could go and borrow some from his colleague. So he went there and borrowed 2, 3, 4. And how could that be recorded? Actually, they don't belong to him. So the idea of negativity comes in. So how could that be? Then that actually resulted in a group of mathematicians, after serious consideration, came to realize that, okay, we accept negative numbers as also being part of the number system. So you have negative numbers together with the already existing numbers, and we denote that as integers. So we have the next one as integers. Integers with a symbol greater C. So we have numbers from somewhere. So we have negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2, and this continues. Alright. So these things were okay, and everybody was living in peace. Until we realized that one particular farmer wants to go and borrow. He was not able to buy fertilizer for the animal, so he wants to go and borrow some from his colleague. And the person will have to divide the sack of fertilizer into certain proportions so that he could give the person some. And that brings about fractions. So in looking at that, we realize that, okay, so from this we can look at another set of numbers we want to look at, we want to name as rational numbers. So we have the 3 numbers that we want to call rational numbers. Right, so we denote that with Q. And what that means is that these numbers, they are just numbers that can be written in the form A divided by what B. So they are in the form this. And what A and B are integers. And we have a very important condition, which is that B can't be 0. So we have the set of natural, the set of rational numbers. Now we realize that since A and B can be integers, then this set here falls into the arena of rational numbers. Similarly, natural numbers and whole numbers can be found or can be looked at as rational numbers. So rational numbers can be considered as a collection of natural numbers, whole numbers, and integers. Now these things were okay. Until we realized that, okay, what if we have rational numbers? Then it could be possible that we also have what? Irrational numbers. So we have irrational numbers, which is the direct opposite of rational numbers. Whereas rational numbers can be written in the form A over B, then we also have irrational numbers. Irrational numbers, which we say that they can't be written in the form A over B. Alright. So the collection of all this. So we say that since rational numbers denote the collection of rational numbers, natural numbers, whole numbers, and integers, then the real number system will be looked at as a combination of rational numbers and irrational numbers. So you can put that in a Venn diagram. Well drawn one. So we have, first of all, this says representing natural numbers. So we have natural numbers. Then after natural numbers, then we have what? Whole numbers. Because from here, that is that every number that can be found in this. So this one becomes a subset of this one. So we have whole numbers, W. So after whole numbers, we have what? Set of integers. The integers coming next. So we have a set of integers. And after that, we have what? The rational numbers, which is what? Q. We have rational numbers, Q. Then we have other numbers, which when we put a very big rectangle, so all the numbers there become the irrational numbers. And we refer to all this as the real number system. Thank you very much for your time. We shall meet again in our next lesson. Thank you very much.